How's it going, movie fans? My name is Jonathan. I am a man of movies, and today on the podcast, I have my wife, Frances, on as we discuss the golden era of Walt Disney animation. That includes Snow White, that includes Pinocchio, Fantasia, Dumbo, and Bambi. This is gonna be a new series on the channel that every now and then when we get done with a specific era, we'll come back and we're gonna discuss it. We're not only gonna talk about our opinions on the movie, we're not only gonna rate the movie, but we're gonna get into some of our earliest memories of the movie. We're gonna get into the theme parks about where can you find certain aspects of these films at Disneyland or Walt Disney World. And if you're into that, stick till the end, because we're gonna rank these five films personally. And real quick, before I head off, wanted to let you guys know that we have been dealing with some technical difficulties, but we were able to fix them. But if you do notice some slight audio drift toward the Snow White section of the video, please forgive me. We tried our best, but I think it came out great. Please continue watching, and to those listening, thank you for listening. You won't have that issue. So, with that being said, let's get into it.
Did you do the recap?
Kind of. I'm just gonna wing it.
I hope what do you mean? What kind of?
I saw a few recaps of just...
But like what recaps?
I saw these YouTubers that just did like 5 minute recaps of every movie.
So the movies that I told you that we're going to talk about,
yes,
right?
Yes.
You didn't go to the next era?
No, just the golden era.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you didn't do all of them?
What do you mean if I did all of them?
Like, did you do something like a Fantasia?
I did like a 5 minute recap.
Because that was one. Like a that package was, film, and it's like...
That was really long, yeah.
I hope you remember some of the shorts in that one.
No, I didn't watch the whole video because he was like very explaining why they were doing all the sounds of Fantasia.
Oh my God.
So I kind of stopped, but like, it did reminded me of
That's not going to be us. We're not going to be doing no video essays like those people. No. We're just going to talk about, hey, we saw these movies and we have opinions and that's it. And we want to just talk about the movies and we want to just rate them.
Yeah.
And I'm going to rank them in the end, unless you want to as well. But I don't think you're ready for that.
Once you rank them, I'll tell you like my thoughts on
it. My ranking.
Yeah.
I think that's
and
okay.
And then maybe I'll give you like mine.
I think that's okay.
Yeah.
All right. So the first era that we're gonna be doing, because we've been seeing these movies now for like over a year, we never did anything about it, but now we're gonna do something. And the reason is because there's this podcast that I listen to called Disorder, and they go through each film and they go in depth, and I just love the way they did it. And I'm like, I want to do something like that where I can watch the Disney films, because I love Disney films and we love Disney films, and we could talk about them. And I want to do it the way they do it, but with our little spin on it. That's why this is what this ultimately I want it to be.
Okay,
so with that being said, the first era is the golden era. Some people call it the golden age. It's the same thing. I'm just going to call it the golden era, which was between 1937 and 1942. So this is ages ago.
That's crazy. It was that time.
1937, bro.
Hi-ho, 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 it's home from earth we go. Hi-ho, 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 hi-ho.
I was watching a video on Snow White.
Okay.
And every time I saw Snow White, I always thought it was the first animated film that was black color and first like human like kind of form,
really?
Kind of like a similar. I always thought it was, but it wasn't. It those other films before then. But the funny thing was that they did people, but they didn't know how to do movements with the people. So whenever I saw a video of like it was a lady walking like this, like skeleton, like not a.
Well, that's why they were always so like cartoony.
Yeah, yeah. They didn't know how to have it more like how to move their arms. They didn't know how to have that animation very realistic.
So what'd they do?
So Snow White was the first one ever to actually have like that real movement.
But do they tell you how they were able to do that?
They said they had a budget for Snow White that was like a few thousand dollars, and they
I'm sure it was like
it was like a million, almost like $2 million. That was a lot for the time.
We'll get to the Snow White part of it all, but the golden era, because all these eras are defined, they have their own definition. There's a reason why they're called the golden era, they're called this era, whatever era. It's called the golden era because this is kind of the era in which started so many of what we would get to know Walt Disney's animation to be. Mm-hmm. It started it off. And not even Walt Disney Animation, what a lot of animation in general in the future would become stems from whatever critical success the golden era was. Yeah. And so, oh man, hold on. I have some info here, but I have this on airplane mode in case somebody calls me. But it was a lot of just, like I said, critical success and the way that it was able to influence the other eras of Disney and other eras of other animation studios, which, like you said, starts off with Snow White back in 1937, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, which is, spoiler alert, the only real success in the golden era. Like you said, they made it for whatever, and it made so much money back that Disney was so shocked. Like, goodness. I heard something like tickets back in 1937 could go for 20 cents. And Snow White tickets were like going for like $5. Wow. So like imagine how expensive it was and that everybody wanted to do it. Walt Disney was known for his shorts. He was known for the Alice shorts, which would mix in like some animation with live action type stuff. He was already doing that, shorts with Mickey and like other type of things. And this was the first time that we get a feature length film. I mean, it's almost an hour and a half long. So, I mean, that alone is a big deal. And then it makes all this money and it just blew up. And that's why Snow White is so big for Disney. And when it comes to animation in general, it's humongous for that. But in the end, regardless of its success, what did you think of Snow White? Mm-hmm. Let me ask you the first question, right? Which is, when we saw it, was that your first time watching it? Or did you see it back in the day?
I have a faint memory of it when I was little. But I didn't remember all the details of it. So this was kind of technically my first time really like seeing it. And I probably was way too young when I saw it. That's why I don't have much memory of it.
Gotcha.
But it was technically like my first time.
I saw it, I think, like in high school for the first time. Oof. Well, in reality, I have a really faint memory of me being a child, being in my cousin's room as she was playing it on her TV.
So you weren't even watching it. It was your cousin.
Like it's the scene where she's at the well. So it's like right at the beginning.
Yeah.
And I just remember watching that and that was it. I didn't watch the rest of the movie and I didn't really pick it up till like high school when I saw it from beginning to end. So that was really my first time watching Snow White. And I have a similar story with Halloween, but I knew what Snow White was about, regardless if I saw it or not, because of the Disney of it all.
Yeah.
It's so old. And even when I was a kid, it was so old. Like, it was nearing 70 years old when I was a kid. So, whether it was from Disney Channel or shorts from other VHS tapes, I knew about the witch and this and the dwarfs. And because of the witch, I was so scared to go and watch the whole movie. So that's the whole similar to Halloween, because it's I was scared of Halloween as a kid. I didn't pick it up till I was in high school. Same with Snow White. I was scared of the witch because she was at the parks. They had that one ride at Disney. We'll get to that stuff later. But because of that, I knew the witch would be in Snow White. And so I didn't pick it up again till high school. And that's really my story with Snow White. And I don't know if you were scared of the witch.
I was not scared
of the witch. Oh, I was terrified of the witch. And I we'll get into that when we get into the theme park section of Snow White. But we have other movies to go through. So what works for you about Snow White? What doesn't work for you about Snow White? Is there anything that doesn't work for you? Is it just a perfect movie? What is it?
I really liked it. I think it ranks like really high for me just because it's so timeless. It's such a timeless movie. And I think that's where it all began with all the princesses and everything. So you kind of see it off like very classic. That's the word. I think the only thing I didn't like that when I was recapping it today, it was just like her voice. For some reason, I was listening to her voice. But then I remembered the time that it was created and the time that, like, I think it was very trending of the time because they had Betty Boo around the same time, too, with that voice. Like,
very high pitch, like, very little girl. It's almost like a little girl.
Yeah.
Yeah,
very high pitch. So I think they were going for it being of the time, kind of like that vibe. And so I feel like that didn't age well for me.
I like what you say when it comes about like it's like what inspired the princess movies that were gonna come. I think the golden era, the movies we're gonna be touching on, does the same thing.
Yeah.
Whether you want to talk about the princesses with Snow White, or you want to talk about the fairy tales with Pinocchio, or you want to talk about the animals with Bambi later on, the golden era seriously like just inspired the rest of what we're gonna be seeing. And when it comes to the voice, I mean, it's annoying. It's very high-pitched. It's very, like, ringing to the ears type of voice. I have heard something that the voice of Snow White had some, like, really strict contract by Walt Disney that he wouldn't even let her work on anything else. Really? And I think she ended up having a super small role in The Wizard of Oz. And after that, like, she never worked. Did anything else. Like, that's how crazy strict that contract was that Walt Disney wanted to, like, really make her voice such a legacy. Yeah, that's his voice.
Jeez.
And here's the thing about Snow White. I really like Snow White as well. I don't think it's up there in the grand scheme of the 60-plus Walt Disney animated movies that they have. But it's definitely, like, I love a film that has an impact. I love a film that causes other films to be influenced by it. And because of that, Snow White is up there for me. But it's not my favorite Walt Disney animated movie.
But golden era.
Like, it's really good.
This is not my favorite movie of all time of Disney.
But the golden era? Not even the golden era. But it's good. Okay. It's good. I really enjoy it. The issues I have with the film, and they're so forgivable. It's not something that makes me angry. It's just something that I have to, like, if I have to rank it, this is why it's not as high as it is. There are scenes, and maybe this is because they've never made something so long, where it just drags on.
Really? At what part?
Like, scenes of Snow White just cleaning.
But that was nice.
I mean,
the part where she cleans with the seven drawers.
Like, but they're not even there yet.
But that's the whole point. It's setting up for, like, her kind of, like,
it's cleaning a setup. It sure is a setup. You're right.
I like that part. I don't know. I don't agree.
And then the part where the dwarves have to wash their hands. And like that just goes on and on and on. I'm like, man, this scene is so long. Or the scene when the dwarves get home. And they like, somebody's in here. And they're all like trying to like slowly creep up the stairs and see who's in their bed. That's like another like 5 minutes. And I'm like,
I don't agree.
This does not have to take as long as it does.
I liked how that it took that long.
Why?
I don't know. In anticipation. Kind of like them walking up.
If a movie like Encanto had scenes like that, I feel like you would not think that. I feel like you'd be like,
shorter extensions.
Attention spans?
Yeah.
100%. Yeah. I agree with you. I think we have shorter attention spans. And that is me putting that into account and still just saying.
It was too long.
I still think it was too long.
I don't agree. I kind of like it. I like it.
I think that was my biggest thing that I didn't like about Snow White.
I don't agree with that.
But that's it. Because everything else, I think it works so well. I think who Snow White is supposed to be, it's so simple. It's so meek, right? Like, she doesn't have, like, the greatest character development.
Think about,
because
the guy.
Oh, the prince.
Yeah, the prince.
That's a weird one.
Yeah, because he's never on it. He's on it in the beginning and then at the end.
Yeah, he, like, kisses her.
Yeah.
People call it, what is it, necrophilia? Because she's dead and he kisses a dead corpse. Yeah. It's weird.
But she's not dead. I think she, the witch did, like, a...
She's dead. Listen, it's just, it's Disney dead, right? What's Disney dead? They're just asleep.
Okay.
But they could come back. That's Disney dead. Okay. She was
she's
dead.
She's, like, frozen to me. Like, it's just her
technically,
frozen body.
Yes, that's exactly what they tried to do.
Yeah.
It's a sign of the times. It wouldn't work today. If something like that happened, like Frozen is the one movie in which they decided to, like, twist it on its head, and it's not about the prince, but that's where it started, and it's cute and it's charming for that, and that's why I appreciate it so much. Character-wise, like, I really like the dwarfs.
Yeah.
All of them, all seven of them. I even like the evil queen when she becomes the witch. Even though I was scared as a child, I think it works. I think it's a classic villain. And the story, for as simple as it is, works. It was the first of its kind. Like, what can you say?
That's crazy. When you think about the time and what they did, and then Snow White just comes out of nowhere. Like,
and that's it.
That's crazy.
And that's truly it. Your favorite song from Snow White, what is it?
The one that the seven dwarves sing.
Hi ho. That one. I like. Yeah. That's a catchy song. It's definitely catchy. It's not my favorite. I think my favorite has to be Someday My Prince Will Come.
Yeah.
I think that's the song when you think of Snow White.
Yeah.
When you think of Snow White and the seven dwarves, it's like you think of hi ho, hi ho. I get it. I get it.
It's just fun.
But when I think of Snow White, I think of One Day My Prince Will Come. Like, that's the song, I think, that if it was nominated for Best Song at the Oscars, that's the song. Mm-hmm. It wouldn't be Hi-Ho. It would have been Someday My Prince Will Come.
Do you know if they were nominated?
Yeah, I got some facts here.
Okay.
I got three facts for each film. And so, for Snow White, the facts I have is that it was nominated for Best Score at the Oscars. Okay.
Nominated.
It was nominated, but it won an honorary Oscar for Walt Disney for innovation. The fact that it was the first of its kind.
Yeah.
And Walt Disney won an Oscar, and then seven little Oscars.
Okay. When seven little.
Yeah, Shirley Temple.
I think you showed me that one.
You know Shirley Temple?
Yeah.
So Shirley Temple was the one who presented the Oscar to Walt Disney, and it was one regular Oscar and then seven little Oscars for the seven dwarfs. What's crazy is that I saw those Oscars with my own eyes, because back in Hollywood Studios here in Florida, they used to have where Star Wars is, the Star Wars launch bay, used to be like an animation courtyard, and there was a room where they had a lot of the awards that Walt Disney won, and they had his Oscar and the seven little ones that he won there in display, and I saw it.
Wow.
Yeah, I don't know where it is now, but to be able to see that, that's crazy.
Wow.
And I think the last fact, do I have one? The last one is okay. It's they had like 50 other names for the dwarfs. Like, there was like a Wheezy and an Awful and a whatever. Mm-hmm. Like, so a Gabby. Maybe there was gonna be a female dwarf. Yeah. A lot of really different ones.
We won an award at a cruise.
Oh yeah, when we went to the Disney cruise, Disney Dream. And a whole bunch of people tied, and we got like this medal, and the last question was a tiebreaker question: can you name all seven dwarfs? And we were able to name all seven dwarfs, us and like two other people. So it was like a three-way tie in the end. So in terms of theme parks, I want to talk about theme parks. When it comes to Snow White, there's a lot, but what's like one that really sticks out to you?
Attraction.
Anything
at the parks? I mean, the Mine Train, that's the one that pops up
it's
in
fun.
My head. You don't like that one?
I like it, not for the wait.
But you complain about it all the time.
No, not for an hour.
Yeah,
an
the wait, the wait is a lot, but I think it's a fun ride.
I like it.
Yeah, what other ones are there?
No, for me, it's gotta be, and they don't have it anymore, but they still have it in California. and it's like Snow White scary adventure or whatever. That and it's the same exact one they have in California that we did. They used to have it here. Yeah. And I used to ride it as a kid.
Scary though.
It was scary, and that's where it comes back with the witch. Mm-hmm. So even though I haven't seen Snow White, there is a scene in there where one of the models they have, it's the evil queen, and she turns around, and it's like this jump scare of the witch. And I remember as a small kid riding with my father, and I would like dig into his side because I was terrified of that witch. Yeah. And so that, again, going back around as to why it took me forever to get back to Snow White, I did not like that. I think it's called like Snow White's Scary Adventure for a reason. It is.
Yeah.
And it's truly scary. Yeah. It's really scary. I mean, even the mind train has a scary moment that when we first wrote it, you kind of like, what the heck? Do you know which one I'm talking about?
At the beginning? No, not the
What's in the beginning?
I thought it was like, it's been a while.
No, the beginning just takes off, right?
Oh, maybe.
It's at the end where you see them at the cottage and they're dancing. And as it keeps moving forward, at the door is the animatronic of the witch.
Yeah,
and that, you kind of jump
that,
back.
That was scary. Yeah,
because it's scary.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm telling you. Okay. Like, it's just scary.
Is there anything else? The parks?
Yeah, 1,000,000,000 things. I mean, you have Snow White. You can take pictures with her. There's seven doors.
I mean, like, attraction-wise or like
attraction-wise, I mean, the mine train, the one in California. I know that you can meet Snow White in... Is it Wilderness Lodge that they have a dine-in experience that you could dine in with Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs? And it's like a story time thing. And I wish I knew the name of it, but I think it's Wilderness Lodge that does it.
Maybe. I've heard of it, but
like
I don't
Whispering
know which
Canyon, I think, is the dine-in. I'm not 100% sure. But you could meet her there. It's like a story time where they kind of reenact the story in front of everybody that's eating. I've always wanted to do it.
Yeah.
What would you rate the movie?
1 out of 10.
Out of 10.
I'd rate it an 8.
So that's like a 4 out of 5.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think an 8 is good.
I think that might be good.
Yeah.
A 4 out of 5?
Mm-hmm.
I think I will give it a 4 out of 5.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's good.
Yeah, I'd give it a 4 out of 5 as well. Yeah. If you don't have anything else to say about Snow White, we're going to move on.
Let's move on.
Okay. Now, we're moving on to 1940 with the release of Pinocchio.
I got no strings to hold me down, to make me red or make me brown. I hit strings, but now I'm free. There are no strings on me. Hi, ho, the Mario, that's the only way to be. I want the world to know nothing ever worries me.
And this is a big one, because to many people, this is still the best that Walt Disney has ever gotten.
That's what people think.
I don't know if I agree with those people.
I love Pinocchio.
But I understand those people.
Yeah.
I mean, this is like one of the best golden era films.
Yeah.
When we watched it, I don't think it was your first time, right? You've seen it. Like,
yeah, I've seen it.
Okay,
yeah,
so
that
what
was
your
one of
memory
my favorite,
with that?
It was one of my favorite movies when I was growing up.
Mm.
I think it was just the feeling of it, of just seeing him, like Pinocchio, just like become a kid, and then the struggles of life, just like hitting, and then temptations, and then I felt like very, like I was like very relating to it, sort of, when I was growing up. I was like, oh, there's so many things hitting me, but I should just find my way home, and so I think that's why I always liked it.
So like hit you on a real level.
Yeah, it hit me on a real level.
This movie didn't hit me on a real level.
As a kid.
Okay.
I feel like now I see it a little different when we saw it.
Gotcha.
I think I was like a part. I'm like, wait, why did I like this? Because it's kind of crazy. There's some parts that
it is.
A kid shouldn't be seeing too.
Yeah.
But what are your thoughts?
So funny that you say that too, because another name for the golden era is the tar and sugar era, and they call it the tar and sugar era because. And you've noticed, we've seen all of them, is amongst the child-friendly imagery, there is also some very dark, adult, scary type imagery that maybe isn't meant for children. And Pinocchio definitely has a lot of that. We talked about it with the witch. I think the witch is one of those where it's like, that is very scary.
Yeah,
She dies. Like, she falls off a cliff and dies. And in Pinocchio, a lot of stuff happens in terror. Like, the boys get turned into donkeys. And they're partying. Crying.
They party. They smoke.
I want my mom.
That's crazy.
And
we never see them.
It never gets resolved. Yeah. Like, that's horrible.
They just disappear. I don't know why I liked that as a kid. As seeing it as an adult, I was like, why did I find this enjoyable?
It's enjoyable, but it's just dark.
It's really dark.
The first time I ever saw Pinocchio, you bought the movie for me on Blu-ray. Mm-hmm. I never saw Pinocchio in my whole life, but it's a similar thing of I knew about Pinocchio. I knew about the story of Pinocchio. There was nothing new when I finally did see it because I knew all about it. It was mm-hmm. spoiled to hell for me. But I really liked it. I thought, like, I understand why people call this a perfect movie. I mean, geez, if I see this movie a couple more times, I could probably call this a perfect movie. But I don't have the nostalgia that someone like you and somebody else that holds it so high has, where they, like, grew up with it and this, that, and the other. And I didn't. But I still really enjoyed it. I remember watching it and going, this is so good. The second time we watched it was to start doing this thing, right? Our little watch along where we're going to see all the Walt Disney movies. I felt a little different. I saw more of its flaws than I did the first time.
What are the flaws?
Well, the first thing is I think Pinocchio is a piece of crap.
he gets really annoying.
He's just annoying.
Yeah.
And you could try and debate me, and you could try and go, but he learns the whole thing. He's a kid, and he's naive.
It's his first time really out and about.
It's his first time ever being alive.
He's very clueless, and
he goes to school the next morning.
So you gotta give him a break.
I give him a break, right? Like, so that's why, like, Pinocchio. I don't hate Pinocchio, but he is so annoying, right? It's like in real life, if there was a kid like him and I knew his backstory, there's a little bit of me that wants to show him some grace and go, give him a break. Mm-hmm. But still, I wouldn't want to hang out with him. Like, he's annoying.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. I get it, Pinocchio. I understand. I'm going to cut you some slack. Mm-hmm. But we're not friends.
We're not friends.
I don't know. I kind of still feel the same way about Pinocchio, where it's like he's kind of cute and all.
Yeah.
But he's annoying.
Yeah, I don't agree with you. I think you have to give him a little bit of grace more than you are. Because Tito, like, he's literally been born for a day or two.
Uh-huh.
And he just wants to make his father proud. And be
he always wants to make his father proud by doing the exact opposite of what his father wants him to do.
But he's trying to be famous and make money and have his dad live a better life.
Okay, so what's a scene that sticks out to you about Pinocchio?
I mean, now as an adult, I feel like just the donkey part just creeps in my head constantly. The donkey screaming, those kids screaming.
And then, stands out for sure.
And then at the like, what is it? Land? What's the
Pleasure
land?
Island. Pleasure Island, yeah.
That they just do whatever they want. And that's crazy. I can't believe that was a thing.
This is hard. I don't know if there's a standout scene for me. Like, I think the whole movie is so good that I could pick so many scenes that stand out to me. For better or for worse. Like, in the sense of worse, like, the donkeys. I understand. But, like, so many scenes that work, man. I've Got No Strings. It's such a catchy tune. The part with Monstro, the whale, like, everything.
Oh,
the whale.
Oh, that was my favorite part as a kid. I just remembered. It was the whale. There's I think so it just reminded scenes. Me of the Bible.
Oh, yeah, Jonah.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll pick the whole interaction he has with... what's his name? I think his foul fellow. He's the fox. Just that whole sequence of him and Gideon trying to get Pinocchio.
Yeah.
And they convince him with the actor's life for me. Dum diddly dee, an actor's life for me. I really like that. And I mean, it's the beginning of the end for Pinocchio. I understand that. Mm-hmm. But it's a sequence that just screams Disney to me. And that's why I like it so much.
Yeah. I hate him. He's annoying. He's the one that's annoying, not Pinocchio.
I mean, he's not a good guy.
No.
I think his name is literally Foul Fellow, I believe, which means, like, he's not a good person.
Yeah.
But Pinocchio, man, song-wise, what's one that really sticks out to you?
Strings in Me, for sure.
Nah. I'm about to kill you right now.
Why?
Because it's the Disney theme song, When You Wish Upon a Star, that comes from Pinocchio. that's the song.
Yeah.
Right? Like, that is the song. Like, that is literally the song. Yeah. But I've Got No Strings is a good one.
I just like the fun songs.
And I really like An Actor's Life.
Yeah.
Because it reminds me of Pirates. It's almost the same beat of yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's life for me. And it's almost the same thing. And this was before Pirates.
Yeah.
I mean, this was like 13 years before the freaking park even opened. So maybe that's where they got it from, was Pinocchio.
Yeah.
But I really enjoyed it, man. I really enjoyed Pinocchio. I think it's a near perfect movie. Pinocchio's annoying, yes, but...
No.
He's annoying, but I still like him. Yeah. I like Pinocchio as a character, but he's just annoying. Okay, like that's it. Like, I don't hate him. I like Pinocchio. I really do. But any thoughts before we go to the theme parks? Mm-hmm. Final thoughts on the film?
No, cover it all.
I think we covered it all.
Yeah, you want to rank them?
Near perfect. No, let's go to the theme parks real quick. Pinocchio. Where can we see him? What have you done? What would you recommend?
Disneyland.
I think it's called Pinocchio's Daring Journey or Daring Adventure or something like that.
I barely remember it though. I like the whale that they have.
Oh yeah, that's in Storybook Canal or something, where you go in the boat and you go into Monstro's mouth. That's dope.
That was really cute.
That was really cool.
It's like you're going really into his mouth, which, well, you literally do.
Yeah,
but it's really nice.
That was really cool.
That's what stands out to me.
But the dark ride, you're right. I don't really remember the dark ride.
It's just the dark rides. It's very easy to forget because it's dark, and then only a few things pop out, and then it's over.
I don't know.
So maybe that's not one of
We're a whole rides. Era away.
Yeah.
But once we get to Mr. Toad, that's something that I want to touch on, because that was a good ride.
That was a good one.
They have the restaurant in Magic Kingdom that we never eat at.
But we go and sit down and chill.
You want to tell everybody about the awkward experience you had?
Which one? I always have so many awkward experiences.
It was at the restaurant where they have the book that you write your wish down. And what happened? That we were kind of like, let's get out of here.
Cause... Wait, you tell it because you're better.
Okay, so what happened is, I think it's called Pinocchio's Village House.
Yeah.
And it's a quick service food place. I think they have pizzas now. They change all the time. And in there, they have a book that you write your wish down.
Mm-hmm.
And as we're writing our wish down, one of the cast members comes to, and it's nothing with the cat. He was a cool guy. It was just a little awkward is all. And we're very awkward people.
Yeah.
And because we're very awkward people, when people get really awkward, we get extra awkward and just leave. And so what happens is this cast member comes up to us and he goes, oh, did you write down your wish? And we're like, oh, yeah, we wrote down our wish. And he's like, come over here to you. He goes, come over here. Close your eyes. And you close your eyes, and I'm waiting there for a minute. He puts his arm like under the desk, and he starts pressing a button. It's not working, and he goes, "Hold on."
You hear it, and then after,
and he goes, "You hear it?"
And I'm like, "Yeah, I'm not hearing anything."
And I'm like, "Do you hear it?" And then I'm like, "What are we supposed to hear?" And he does it again. And what it was is like a twinkling noise.
Yeah.
It's so faint, you can't even hear it. And he goes, that was the blue fairy. She came to grant your wish.
Wow, yes, I heard it.
I left.
And
we just left right after that. Like, that was so awkward. It didn't work. He tried 1,000 times. You couldn't even hear the twinkling. Yeah. Did you hear it?
It was the fairy.
It was the blue fairy. She came to grant your wish.
Wow,
not yet.
Hear it.
Not yet.
No, but before that too, we wrote our wish, but we wanted to read everybody else's wish. So we were also waiting after he asked us. Yeah, he was like, "Oh, did you write your wish? Can I see it?" And I'm here like, because we already moved it. So it was awkward because of that. So he had to wait.
It's a humongous book. Yeah,
he had to wait until we found our wish for him to be like, "Okay, close your eyes," and us waiting. It was a mess.
Yeah.
It didn't work out.
No, it didn't work out at all. But
that was a good memory.
Yeah, that was funny. And then the other day we went to Hollywood Studios and they had a surprise appearance by Pinocchio. We didn't end up taking a picture with him.
We did see him.
We had to go to the nursery to change Francia. But that was really cool because you never see Pinocchio.
Yeah.
You never see Pinocchio. So, hey, Hollywood Studios by the nursery. Sometimes Pinocchio's there.
Yeah.
Rate the film.
I want to give it a 9, but I don't know.
A 9 is like it's 4.5 out of 5.
Maybe I should give it 8 also.
Bro, you're tripping. Wow. And you're the one here talking the best things about Pinocchio.
I'm compared to other things. Maybe should I compare it to just this era?
Pinocchio. Just Pinocchio's Pinocchio.
Man, I want to give it a 9, but I just don't know. Or maybe an 8.5. I feel like 8.5 for me.
Wow.
Yeah, 8.5.
I'm higher than you.
Really?
8.5, yeah. That's like a 4.25 out of 5. I don't think so. I think I would go as low as 4.5 out of 5. That's the lowest I would go, which is a 9 out of 10.
Mm-hmm.
That's the lowest I would go.
I'm surprised.
And it would be as high, because I'm telling you, like, it is near perfect, mm-hmm. if not perfect. Like, the only thing I don't like about it is that Pinocchio annoys me. But that's just a personal thing, because I understand that he is charming. Mm-hmm. Jonathan Martinez wouldn't be friends with Pinocchio. But him as a character, it's great.
Wow. I'm surprised. Because he always complains about
it. It's near perfect for me.
Wow.
Okay. Listen, truly.
Okay.
So, with that being said, we are moving on now to the next film, which is also in 1940.
Mm-hmm.
Fantasia. Okay, just start it. Go ahead. Oh, no. Hold on. Before you say that, when we saw it, was that the first time you saw it, or did you see it before?
It was my first time.
It was all okay. So it's the same. Yeah. We watched it together for the first time.
Yeah.
I think it took us like 3 days.
It did. To watch one movie, it took us 3 days.
It's the longest Walt Disney animated movie.
Yeah.
I think it's at 2 hours.
That's insane.
But it's not even that long for a movie.
For a movie, yeah. We've seen other movies that are longer in one day.
Yeah.
But this one was just so bad that we couldn't even see it for too long.
I feel bad even saying that it's bad, because it's like so classic.
I mean, for what it meant to do, I think it did a really good job.
Sure.
It's just for the time. One, for the time. Mm. Second, I see what they were trying to do. Maybe it's just not our cup of tea, because people love it. People are obsessed with this.
People love it, but you'd be surprised, mm-hmm. because I've listened to many a podcast and many YouTube videos, mm-hmm. and as much as there are people that love this movie and like think it's one of the best, there are people that are like us and they go, dang, this definitely was a product of its time.
Mm-hmm. I think people overhyped it for me. Or maybe Disney overhyped it for me.
I think Disney overhyped it for me. Because I know very little people that have actually seen Fantasia.
Yeah. I think it was Disney going into Disney Channel and seeing the animation, or going into Disney and seeing
great movie ride.
Yeah, the hat.
Yeah, the sorcerer hat.
Yeah, like all that.
Fantasmic, which is like a kind of close to Fantasia.
Yeah.
Sorcerer Mickey's everywhere. This was
going to be the best movie made.
Sorcerer Mickey's everywhere. Yeah. Like I said, the great movie ride had a whole scene about Fantasia. Mm-hmm.
Didn't we fall asleep? And that's why we kept having to stop.
Yeah, especially me.
Yeah.
Like, it's hard for me to stay up nowadays. And so Fantasia did me no favors whatsoever.
It's a lot of shorts, but nobody really talking.
It's the first package film.
And it's just slow music.
Yeah.
So the thing that they were trying to do is create, like,
pictures to go with the sound.
Picture to go with the sound. Exactly.
Yes, I understand.
So it did its job.
It did its job.
But that was it.
I think
it wasn't entertaining though.
It was not.
Yeah.
It was not entertaining at all. Like, seriously. Like, there's one or two that I really liked, but one or two shorts doesn't make a good movie. It just makes one or two good shorts.
Yeah.
The Sorcerer's Apprentice, which is the Sorcerer Mickey one, mm-hmm. which a lot of people don't even like that one because...
I didn't like it that much.
I liked it.
I was...
If something's like extra Disney, I'm with it. It's like why I like that scene in Pinocchio, because it feels Disney to me.
I was just expecting a lot more.
I knew exactly what I was expecting.
So it wasn't that good.
Really? Yeah. No, I'm with it. And then knowing me, I really like Night at Bald Mountain, which is the one with Chernabog, the big devil that comes out of the mountain. I think it's Halloween and all the demons and the skeletons are coming out and terrorizing this town. But then as the sun rises, everything like gets back to normal. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
That one is so well done.
Yeah.
There are some really good bouts of animation. Mm-hmm. When you think about, I even told you, what if they made a Fantasia 2024?
I think they could do
really where what they do is, hey, check out how we're pushing the medium forward right now. I think I could
They should do that.
With the classical music and be like, wow, they're pushing it. That's crazy. I think I like that. But because we're so far removed from that era, I look at it and go, well, I'm sure that was great back in 1940. But it's really boring me to tears right now.
Yeah.
That's how I feel.
Yeah.
You know?
That's it. I don't have anything else to say about it.
No, yeah. So something I haven't mentioned before, with Snow White being so successful, they thought from that here on out, it was just going to be banger after banger. And it really wasn't. Not even Pinocchio. They didn't make their money back. They were flops.
But I think I heard with Pinocchio, that's when the war started.
I think, yeah.
So a lot of people couldn't go see it. But when it came out in VHS, it made a lot of money then.
So, yeah.
But you're not wrong. Because of the war, a lot of people couldn't go and see it.
That's when everything started. Yeah. It's like, it sucks for Disney because they were on a roll with Snow White. Like, you're right. World War II came to us. And it was time to like, oh, no. Like, yeah, like certain countries could even see Pinocchio.
Yeah.
Right. And Disney, what they used to do is re-release their films. They used to release it every 10 years or so. Until VHSs were a thing and you could finally buy them and watch it at home.
Yeah.
All these movies that we're going to talk about that flopped upon opening all made their money back and more. Like even Fantasia, right?
Yeah.
But it was not good at first, especially Fantasia. Fantasia was a weird one because Disney was trying to get people on board to come watch this movie because it was so experimental at the time, which I appreciate. But because it was so experimental, a lot of people just kind of dismissed it.
Yeah.
Fantasia. Now, talking about Fantasia, I'm trying to see, is there a song in Fantasia? What's your favorite short? I was like, it's not really a song because it's a lot of classical music written by other people.
Is it from Fantasia? It's a blur to me. Everything just
bro, don't even start because once we get to the wartime era,
don't remind me.
So many package films. I don't even remember some of the shorts there.
I'm remembering like these horses, people.
Yeah.
What?
I think it's called The Rites of Spring.
Yeah, I think that one's the only one I can remember.
It's the one with like.
And it stands out to me.
Yeah, I forget what they're called. The centaurs?
Yeah.
No, I don't think it's centaurs.
It's
the half horse, half man, half human type. Yeah.
And they fall in love.
Super colorful. And, they have the unicorns.
Yeah.
And it's also fun fact, I think the only film in which they show nudity. Because I think one of the female centaurs or whatever they're called, they're just showing their breasts.
Yeah. Oh, I saw a video actually that they had to. I saw a video that they had to cut one of the scenes or edit it.
Oh, because of the black.
Yes.
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 That's
so
crazy.
That's so.
We didn't see it.
We didn't see it.
Yeah, because we saw the Disney Plus version, but it's one that's like, it's a black centaur, whatever they're called,
like
serving the white centaurs, and bro, that would have been crazy. But for the sake of history, I would have liked to see it. It's like, I can't believe they did that.
They show it on YouTube a little bit.
Oh really?
That's where I
the Disney Plus version completely cut that out.
They cut
Disney Plus cuts a lot of stuff out, but then they leave a lot of stuff in.
Yeah,
right.
And they'll like, just like have like cautious signs. Of like,
yeah, they have almost all of these movies start with the caution. This has depictions of this, that, or the other. Mm-hmm. Fantasia wasn't it, Francis. It really wasn't. Not for me. Do you have anything else to say about this film? Any final thoughts?
Not really.
I think all I have to say is like I appreciate Fantasia. Mm-hmm. I think it did a lot moving the medium forward. But as its standalone thing, like I just don't appreciate it. Like. as a standalone thing.
Yeah.
It bored me to tears. It's not entertaining.
Same.
There's a few shorts I enjoy, but a few shorts just doesn't make a good movie. It just makes a few good shorts, like I mentioned, and that's it. That's all I really gotta say about Fantasia. Mm-hmm. Theme park wise, where can we find anything Fantasia?
Everywhere. I think there's like toys everywhere.
Technically, you're right.
There's not a ride.
Well, they
have the 3D.
Oh, Philharmagic.
Yeah, Philharmagic.
That has Sorcerer Mickey.
Yeah. And I think that's it. It has like the music and the kind of.
It's very music. Yeah.
So I feel like that's.
There's a lot of posters there, like fake posters of certain shorts of Fantasia and even certain shorts from other eras. What was I going to say? It was my birthday a few years ago, we went to Fantasia Gardens to do mini golf.
Oh, yeah, we did.
Which is a complete mini golf course, all Fantasia. Mm-hmm. All, like, each short of Fantasia, and you get to do a mini golf.
That was really nice.
That was cool. Again, it's like the parks hyped it up for me. Disney hyped it up for me, and the movie just didn't hit. Fantasmic, which is close. Mm-hmm. Sorcerer Mickey, villains, music. And I think that's pretty much it.
Was there anything in Disneyland? Do you remember?
Of Fantasia?
Yeah.
In Disneyland?
I don't remember anything.
Mm-mm. And I know a lot of parades from back in the day, maybe even some today that we're not thinking of, have Fantasia type stuff, like the crocodile and the hippo, the ballet, right? Like you always see them in parades, even if it's just like the spinning figures, like it's just them. So Disney definitely hyped it up for us, and it didn't deliver.
It didn't.
What would you rate it?
I'll give it a 3 out of 10.
Wow, that was a really long burp.
It was. I was trying to ignore it.
I put my microphone away, but it was really loud. I'm with you. I think a 3 out of 5, honestly, is a 3 out of 5. Yeah. I can't go any lower just because of its significance. I really can't
three
go
out of
any.
10.
3 out of 10. Heck, no, that's low. No, 3 out of 5. Oh, so that's like a 6 out of 10.
So that's high.
That's a 6 Jeez. Out of 10.
Yeah.
You just said the same thing.
No, I said 3 out of 10.
3 out of 10? Damn.
I hated it. You have no idea.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. What is that? Like a 1.5 out of 5? You would give it a 1.5 out of 5. You're tripping. I would give it a 3.
I can't. I give it a 3 because it has some good shorts. Like one.
Well, I don't know what you're trying to debate.
That's it.
But at least I gave it a 3 out of 10, which is like a horrible grade, like the worst movie ever seen.
It did get a really bad grade.
That's insane.
Yeah.
I don't know if I agree. Anyway, some fun facts for Fantasia. It won 2 honorary Oscars for unique achievement in the art form.
Wow.
Deserving, I think. I think it was very unique for that time, right?
Mm-hmm.
Only one of Walt's animated films to reach and exceed 2 hours. I kind of mentioned that. And it is the first appearance of Mickey Mouse in an animated movie because he was in shorts. This was the first time we saw Mickey in an animated movie in The Sorcerer's Apprentice. And they changed up his animation style in this one because Mickey used to look kind of like when you think of Steamboat Willie. And this is the first time we see Mickey look like the Mickey from the parks all those years ago.
A good job.
I think so,
he
too.
He looked good.
All right, next one, which is the second to last one, 1941, we get the release of Dumbo. This is where we see a lot of the war efforts because Disney started to push on its brakes, or more like the U.S. started pushing on Disney's brakes. And Dumbo really suffered because of it.
Is that why it was so short?
And that's why it was so short. It was supposed to be a short film. And Walt was the one that said, let's just push it over the 1 hour mark and make it a feature length film. And that's why, like, they tried their hardest, and they did. They finally got it over the 1 hour mark. when you saw Dumbo, when we saw Dumbo, was that your first time?
It wasn't. But again, that was one of the movies I saw as a kid. So I remember bits and pieces of it, but not all of it. But I always liked Dumbo.
Yeah.
Like going to the parks and seeing Dumbo. Same. And just the idea of him, I've always liked. So I have good memories of the little bit that I seen.
Man, I couldn't even begin to tell you when I remember Dumbo.
You don't?
As far as I remember Dumbo.
Really? The whole thing?
Yeah, all of it. All of it. Like, there's a little bit of when we finally got to see it. I'm like, man, I don't remember it like that. But, dude, I used to watch Dumbo like crazy. I had the VHS to the point where the VHS cover was the hard plastic cover. It was, like, torn to shreds how many times I saw Dumbo. And I really love Dumbo as a character. Mm-hmm. And even though he doesn't talk.
Yeah.
I really love Dumbo as a character and all they do with him at the parks, too.
I forget that he doesn't talk because he does so much emotion.
Yeah.
That I forget he doesn't talk.
I think that's really good, though. Like, the fact, like, the animators did a good job with Dumbo that he doesn't need to talk and he still has so much emotion.
Yeah.
But I'm trying to remember, like, the first time, but there isn't. As long as I can remember, I've always seen Dumbo. And I've always just had really fond memories, like, very cozy memories of Dumbo. Very cozy memories of Dumbo.
Not sad. Because you think Dumbo, you also think sadness and...
Yeah, you're right. I think when I was small, I had a lot of weird emotions with Disney films whenever they would get sad and I wouldn't know exactly how to feel. Because there's that scene in Dumbo where the mom gets taken away.
Yeah.
And you kind of think, like, what if my mom gets taken away? What if I got taken away from my mom? Like, how would that feel? And as a kid, it was a too complicated of an emotion for me to really ponder. Mm-hmm. And I would just ignore it.
Yeah.
But it's true. But aside from that, I mean, it's a very cozy movie.
Have you ever heard of the that Dumbo, the other elephants, you know, how they have like smaller ears in Dumbo?
Uh-huh.
They're Asian.
Asian elephants.
Asian elephant. And then the... elephants that have big ears are usually like African
elephants.
Elephants. So they're saying that they delivered
the wrong elephant.
The wrong elephant.
That's so stupid. That is so dumb.
You think that's stupid?
Yeah, because the whole point of Dumbo is just that. No, it doesn't make sense. That's Jumbo's son.
Yeah, but then he got put in that situation by accident.
No, you know how.
And then, but he's okay. He's normal. This whole time he's normal.
He's not normal at all. Not even for an African elephant.
Not
even for an African elephant. Not even for an African elephant is Dumbo normal. Okay. No. It's a physical deformity that he has that causes him to fly.
I like to think that he's
an Asian elephant. I like to think that he got sent to the wrong mom and his other mom is waiting for him. Like, where's my son?
Oh, so this whole time he didn't lose a mom.
Finding Dumbo.
Yes.
Where's my son?
Finding Dumbo too. There you go.
That's I would hate that. Oh, no. It wouldn't be as cozy.
Okay.
It wouldn't be as cozy for me.
Okay.
But aside from that and Dumbo, talk to me about the movie.
Okay. It's a lot sadder than I remembered it.
Okay.
Seeing it again. So I remember that being really, really sad. And then what stands out to me is like the drunk part.
Oh my goodness.
Isn't that crazy? That he just drinks. I was watching the scene today and he doesn't even take that many gulps. And he's a big elephant. And then he just gets completely wasted.
He gets plastered.
And just sees other elephants. It's like, again, why are they showing this? That's creepy.
Oh, I love that scene.
Really,
it's a fever
creepy
dream.
Yeah. But how do they allow that at a kid's?
Because it's nothing. It's just creepy. It's nothing necessarily wrong with pink elephants on parade. We'll get to pink elephants on parade. I love pink elephants on parade.
To me, it's a lot.
So Dumbo, I think Dumbo is another classic example of like a very Disney movie, very cozy, which is word of the day, ladies and gentlemen, cozy. I'm going to keep using it for Dumbo, especially Dumbo. Man, I thought this movie was really long when I was a kid.
It's really
short. It's an hour. Mm-hmm. An hour.
They did really good, though, with that hour.
Yeah, sure, sure. I'm with you. Like, I like Dumbo. Mm-hmm. I really like Dumbo. But I'd be lying to you if I wasn't a little bit disappointed when I saw, what? That was really fast.
Yeah.
Like, it goes from Dumbo, they don't accept him, mother goes crazy, he meets the Timothy Mouse, mm-hmm. pink elephants on parade, everybody loves Dumbo. That is how long Dumbo is. Like, yeah. Wow, that was really fast.
Yeah.
I liked it. Mm-hmm. I'm with it. But it's like a glorified short film.
Yeah.
Almost. And it's because it's a glorified short film that I don't hold it now as an adult like super, super high. Mm-hmm. Because it's just a glorified short film.
Yeah.
I don't know if you think the same way.
It is so good that I think it's a movie. It's a full movie for me. I don't think it's a glorified short film.
I think it's a glorified short film. Yeah.
Wow. I don't agree with you there. I think
it's good.
It was that good.
For now, Dumbo's that movie, like, I could watch because it's only an hour long.
Yeah.
And I watch it over. No wonder I saw that movie so a thousand times as a kid.
Yeah.
Because it was an hour long and the VHS would just play itself back over and over and over again. So that was one of the things that really shook me with Dumbo. And if I really want to be picky, because it's so short, it resolves way too quickly. If I want to be picky, but honestly, I don't want to be picky. It's a good movie.
Yeah, it's really good. I think they did really good, especially you telling me that it was like they had to cut it short and they had a little bit of a budget to do it.
Did yeah.
You say that? Yeah. So just they did really good.
And it flopped.
Yeah, that's crazy.
So, you know,
I'll buy the DVD.
I mean, just so they can it definitely didn't flop money. Anymore. It made its money back a thousandfold. Favorite song?
Oh, what are the songs?
I think there's two. I don't remember. Right.
Which one?
No, there's a couple. I think there's three. Well, there's more, but there's one that I don't remember at all. There's the one with the Railroad Men. They're singing a song. Mm-hmm. I don't remember that. Okay. Oh, Casey Jr.'s good. Casey Jr. Da, 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 Casey Jr. I like that one. Yeah. That was a fun one. We rode Casey Jr. Yeah. Dang it. Hold on. I got ahead of myself. we'll get to that part.
Okay.
But that's a fun one. The classic Baby Mine.
Mm-hmm.
Baby Mine.
That's my favorite.
That's a good one.
Yeah, that's my favorite.
Pink Elephants on Parade is so catchy.
Yeah, that's just so creepy.
Pink Elephants on Parade. Boom, 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 boom.
This reminds me of like the Haunted Mansion towards the end.
Kind of is like that. Yeah. Maybe that's why I like it so much.
Creepy.
And then the last one is, I've been done seen about everything when I see an elephant fly.
Yeah, that one's good.
That's a good one, too. Even though it's a little racist. I've been down, seen about everything. Bro.
Wow.
My favorite song still goes to Baby Mine.
Yeah, that one's really good. That's my favorite.
Baby Mine is such a sentimental, and especially when you have a baby that's yours. It's a song that you sing. Yeah. It's a song that you think back to. And when you're a Disney couple, what's a song that's baby like Baby Mine, and you listen to it and you go, wow, like this is a perfect song, a perfect lullaby. It's such a lullaby song, and the song is singing as she starts rocking like Dumbo and he has to go away. I love Baby Mine. Perfect song. Final thoughts on Dumbo.
Final thoughts. It was good, really good. I probably will rank it really high.
Cozy. I'll leave it there. Very cozy.
Okay, what's your ranking?
No. Let's get the theme parks now.
Theme parks. I keep forgetting. Okay.
Theme parks.
Okay. You go.
The classic Dumbo ride, obviously. The flying elephants.
That's my favorite one. Just because we can go with Francia and ride it. When she was a baby, like newborn, we could have gone.
Yeah, she was.
We went on it.
I think we went on it.
Yeah.
She was a newborn. They let us on it.
That's
and
crazy.
Universal won't even let us on like Cat in the Hat.
That's crazy.
Which is insane.
Yeah.
Dumbo's a lot more, I think, scarier and more like force
super high
than
up.
The stupid Cat in the Hat, right?
Yeah. So.
Which she's 2 years old, can't even go on the ride yet. The Cat in the Hat, I mean.
Yeah. So that's my favorite ride.
Yeah.
We have good memories.
It's good.
Yeah.
It's classic Disney.
Mm-hmm.
Classic Disney. When you think of Disney World, you think of the Dumbo ride.
Yeah.
Like how, and for me, Right, because we went to Disneyland and they had one Dumbo ride in the middle of Fantasyland that disappointed us so bad we didn't even go on it. Mm-hmm. What they do here in Walt Disney World, Dumbo has his own land.
Yeah.
Storybook Circus. Mm-hmm. It's all Dumbo.
It's really good.
It's made for Dumbo.
Yeah.
And we got two Dumbo rides, so that means that we can get through that line a lot quicker. And guess what? You don't even have to wait in line that long if you don't want to, because there's a play area for your kids where they can go and play. And when they're done playing,
they can continue the line.
You can continue the line and go on Dumbo.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's what I love so much about Storybook Circus and what they did so good with Dumbo, right? Yeah. I think that's it. I think there's nothing more to really talk about theme park wise, right?
Yeah, that's pretty much it. It was good.
Yeah. Oh, something they're doing new. I don't know when this is going to come out, but something they're doing new is they're putting up statues of the pink elephants on parade.
Really?
In Storybook Circus. And they're calling it Smellephant on Parade.
Smellephant.
Yeah, because they're not going to be pink elephants. They're going to be different designed elephants. So there's going to be an elephant designed like cotton candy, an elephant designed like caramel apple, a caramel a elephant designed as popcorn, and as you pass by it, you're going to smell that. You're going to smell the popcorn and the caramel apple and the cotton candy. That's why they call it Smellephant.
Really
nice. So the statues are being put up right now.
Really?
And I think sometime in May is when they're going to start with this, actually, like, you can smell.
Wow. We should go and see how that's going.
That's
going
to be dope.
Yeah.
What would you rate Dumbo?
Dumbo, I rate it a 9.
4.5? That's the highest one,
9,
I think, so far.
Yeah. I think that's my favorite one.
No, mine's a 3 out of 5.
3 out of 5?
3 out of 5. That's, yeah. Listen, I like it. I like Dumbo, but it's a glorified short film, and I can't put it any higher. It goes by way too fast. Okay. It gets resolved way too quickly. And as much as I enjoy it, it's a 3 out of 5.
Okay.
It's a good. It's solid. It's a solid 3 out of 5. Not a weak 3 out of 5. A solid 3 out of 5.
Okay,
honestly. Next one is the last one we're going to talk about for the Disney Golden Era. And that is Bambi. Bambi. 1942. Yeah, Bambi. So when we saw Bambi, was that the first time you saw Bambi?
That was my first time.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. So did it live up to its legacy, you think?
I think so. I think it was really good. I think I wasn't expecting a lot of the things that happened.
Okay.
It was a lot longer than I thought it was going to be. It was good.
Yeah, it was my first time as well. I don't know. Like, it's great, Francis.
Really?
Okay. Yeah, like, you're saying it's good.
It's good.
And I'm telling you, like, it's near perfect.
It's really good, yeah.
Like, it shook me.
Really?
It shook me. Oh, no. I got a lot of burps. Lord. Pinocchio, its story is so family oriented, and it's so fun and charming. And Bambi has those aspects, but it's also very real and not afraid to show it in your face that this is life. Bambi's mom dies.
Yeah.
And they just move on, because that's life. That's life.
When he freezes, when he sees his dad.
It's a dark, dark movie. But I think it works so well. Yeah. Now, it's a movie that I think probably needs an age limit or an age restriction. Because I think it can be a little too dark for younger kids. Yeah. Right? It's one of those films that, what happened? Like, you know,
a lot happens though. I feel like there's a lot of things like I can't even remember right now, because it was a lot.
I think it's beautifully animated.
Yeah,
beautifully, beautifully animated. Not even gonna like, beautifully animated. There's it still that part. Holds up.
Like the animation yeah. still holds up.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. Animation day. Still holds up. And yeah. there's that part in the middle of the movie called April Showers. Mm-hmm. Do you remember how that song goes? Mm-mm. Dang. It's like, little April showers. Nah, that's the Inspector Gadget theme song. Nah. Dang, I forget. Yeah, but okay. there's that scene. It starts to rain. And so, like, the flowers start blossoming. Mm-hmm. And, like, spring again. And so everything's coming back to life. The yeah. way that is animated shook me. The way that is animated blew my freaking yeah. mind. Yeah. Right? And there's just a lot of really kid-friendly parts that are so cute, man. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you remember because it's been a while now, but it's when Thumper meets Bambi for the first time, right? Like the little prince is born, and Bambi starts repeating after Thumper, bird, yeah. bird. It's so oh, cute.
It is.
You can call me flower if you like. Oh. I don't mind. Oh. Like, it's so yeah. many cute moments in Bambi that is intertwined with some beautiful animation. And at the same time, put in with real life.
Yeah.
There are some scary, like, don't go into the meadow. Mm-hmm. Man is in the forest.
It's I like that the villain in
is man.
Is man. Yeah.
Is man.
It's yeah. It's us destroying Which, nature.
One of the fun facts for Bambi yeah. is that I forget who put it, but a certain company put man in the top 20 villains of all time, mm. movie villains of all time yeah. is man.
Wow.
It's like legit. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Like there's that scene with one of the pheasants, one of the birds, as man's going through the forest and they're like, be still. Don't move. And the one pheasant is freaking out. He's like, he's getting closer. Okay. And flies away. And all you hear is,
I can't. No. I'm going to cry.
Bro. No. Bambi, I think, is borderline masterpiece.
It's crazy. Yeah.
Borderline masterpiece. And I was so surprised because while Disney's on the Fantasia train, mm-hmm. where's Bambi?
Yeah.
Where's Bambi? Right? Like, I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself, but at the theme parks, where is Bambi?
Yeah, you don't see a lot of Bambi.
You don't see a lot of Bambi. Yeah.
Only in Epcot sometimes for Flower and Garden. But
we'll get to the specifics yeah. in a bit, but there's, like, no Bambi.
Yeah.
And I think it's legit a masterpiece yeah. that's able to juggle a cute, Disney-fied yeah. child's film with a real life movie, like yeah. a real life movie.
I feel like it's just too dark that I feel like a lot of parents complain about it. So it's like they don't want to put it too much in the parks because it's like, yeah. oh, like this is too harsh.
I think and the timeline is so good. Like yeah. Bambi grows up, Thumper grows mm-hmm. up, a flower grows up. They get Twitter-pated. Like the owl says,
yeah.
right? Like they start falling in love because it's that season and they all start to fall in love mm-hmm. and Bambi meets up with that the female deer
yeah,
that he knew when they were young and yeah. and he has to fight for her love and they mm-hmm. have that awesome scene where the two deers are like
yeah.
locking in
you,
and
did you notice that when they were a kid she was all over him
mm.
and then when he grew up he was the one trying to get her attention.
He was Twitter-pated.
Now.
That's yeah, what that means. Yeah. Twitter-pated.
Yeah. But it's like
but he has to fight for her.
That role
he switches. Has to fight for her.
Yeah.
He has to yeah. fight for her. You know what
it's
I mean?
It's realistic.
And then when man goes in the forest and the whole forest goes on fire, mm-hmm. just that whole scene.
Yeah.
You know, all the mm-hmm. animals, Bambi trying to help and save. And at the very end, Bambi becomes the great prince. Mm-hmm. He becomes the great prince of the... What, bro, it's a masterpiece.
It
Do
is,
you understand?
You're convincing me
to start
more, yeah.
off this conversation of Bambi going, it's good.
Yeah,
I liked
you're
it.
You're yeah.
That's oversimplification.
Yeah.
It's a masterpiece.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I really think so. It's yeah. a masterpiece. As for songs, there's not really like anything mm-hmm. that comes to mind.
I do like the score though. I think it goes really well. This is like the first like score in this era that I actually like. That goes when they're running and stuff and the sounds in the background. I think it's...
So here are my three facts. Okay. One of them I already said, which is Man is considered top 20 movie villains of all time. Mm-hmm. I said that. Another fact for Bambi is that it was nominated for 3 Oscars. It didn't win any, but it was nominated for 3. It was nominated for Best Sound Design.
Okay.
It was nominated for Best Song for the opening song, Love is a Song, which I don't remember.
Yeah.
And then it was also nominated for Best Score. So it's funny that you mentioned the score because it was nominated for Best Score at the Oscars. I think
the score was really good.
Yeah. And then, depending on where you look this up in the internet, but you see it wherever you go, and I double checked, triple checked, this is Walt Disney's favorite film.
Really?
That he made.
Wow.
It's Bambi.
Yeah.
And I mean, it makes sense why.
Yeah.
I think he put a lot of effort. Considering the circumstances of they were in the war, Francis, right now, 1942. Wow. We're getting there.
Yeah,
we're getting there, and or we're there. Mm-hmm. And for this movie to be as good as it was with the things they had to work with, that's insane to me. So, any final thoughts on Bambi, or have you said anything? Everything.
No, we said everything. It was really good.
Yeah. What would you rate it?
I think it goes.
Oh, dang. Sorry. I'm like all over the place. What? Theme parks. Let's go to specifics now.
Yes.
You mentioned Epcot.
I sometimes he comes up in Epcot during Flower and Garden Festival.
Uh-huh.
Usually they have like an area for him. One, they have like a, for the butterfly.
Oh, yeah. So in the butterfly little house.
Yeah. We've seen sometimes that they put him
there. They put like a freaking.
Yeah.
Plastic thing of Bambi,
and
which
then
was
they
like
also have
lame.
The outside the
topiaries, I think they're called.
Yeah, of Bambi. What else?
I think Animal Kingdom has the statue of Bambi and Thumper. I could be mistaken.
Yeah, for the 50th that they did.
For the 50th that they left.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
And that's it.
That's it,
bro.
And then in Epcot, that goes away after Flower and Garden, so you don't see it for the rest of the year.
Yeah, you don't see it for the rest of the year, and then you're just left with the two statues in Animal Kingdom,
and that's it.
I'm trying to remember, but like, I think they might have a scene in Fantasmic when the water screen.
Do they? Because I don't even remember. Oh, yeah, they do.
There's like a scene.
Yeah.
But I mean, come on now.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Yeah. That's insane to me. I'm sorry. So
you need to do better.
Yeah. Well, rate Bambi.
Yeah. I'll give it a 9. Are you going to give it a 10?
I think I'm going to go a perfect score for Bambi.
Wow.
I'm going to go a 5 out of 5 for Bambi.
Wow.
Yeah.
Good job, Bambi.
Yeah. I think Bambi's a perfect score for me. Yeah. Wow. So, okay, that's the golden era. We got 5 films. So that's, bro, we gotta start speeding this up once we get to like the later eras and there's like 12 films.
That's going to be a lot.
Because this is us with 5 films.
Yeah.
So anyway.
Okay.
And it's a podcast. I don't care, man. I listen to 3-hour Disney podcasts every day. So if I'm a 3-hour Disney podcast, then that's good for me. I really don't care. The only thing is we probably can't record video because our phones or camera will die.
Yeah, but that's okay.
Yeah.
We'll cut it into like sections or something.
Maybe.
Yeah.
For YouTube.
Yeah.
Anyway, so that is the golden era. Oh, I feel bad because I didn't say the fun facts for Dumbo. So let's go back to Dumbo real quick. It was nominated for Best Original Song for Baby Mine.
Yeah. You said this already. You said the facts.
No.
Okay, no? Okay.
No.
Okay.
No, I didn't. And then it won the Oscar for Best Score, Dumbo. Won for Best Score. It has a great score. I love the score where Dumbo flies for the first time. And there's like that French horn, like, great score. And then another one is that Dumbo is the first and only protagonist to not speak any dialogue in a movie.
Yeah. You're right.
Yeah. Everybody else, every like lead character talks. And there's a fun one that I found out today about Dumbo is that Time Magazine was going to do a fun little cute thing and name Dumbo Mammal of the Year. Like a new Man of the Year.
Yeah. Did they?
They didn't because Pearl Harbor happened when Japan bombed Pearl Harbor. And Time Magazine thought, oh, that's a little cheeky. Let's not do it. We're like, things are getting really serious right now.
Yeah.
But Jeez. It came out that they were going to do it. So Dumbo was going to be on Time Magazine. Yeah. He was big. He was influential. Let's see. What else? Was there something else I was going to mention? I don't think so. Anything that you want to mention about the golden era of Disney?
Compared to the two eras that we've seen, this is the best era so far. That's all I'm going to leave it here. So expect the next one.
Yeah, the next one's going to be a little tough. I think we could make it fun.
Okay.
Man, but there was something else that I wanted to do that I'm not remembering.
You don't have, like, notes?
It'll be good to have notes. And I do have notes, but for some reason, I don't have those notes of what I was going to do. So, yeah, golden era, 1937 to 1942. And that's it.
It was good. I enjoyed it.
Yeah, I enjoyed it as well. Oh! My goodness. The ranking.
The ranking.
Bro, the reason we made this video.
Okay, go for it. Yeah, what's your ranking?
Dios mío. Okay, my ranking for the golden era. At number 5, I have... Fantasia.
Fantasia.
Number 5, good easily. Job. Yep. Easily. Number 4.
I agree.
I remember it. I have Dumbo.
On number 4?
At number 4.
Okay.
I mean, it's a movie. Someone had to be at 4.
Yeah.
And it's
Dumbo.
Yeah, 3, which would be right in the middle, is Snow White.
Okay.
Snow White's right in the middle for me. At 2, bro, and 1 and 2 could flip. Mm-hmm. But as of today, as of this recording, number 2, I have Pinocchio with Bambi being number 1.
I think Bambi fits there.
Yeah, I think Bambi's the best golden era film. And it's one of those movies that as we move on, it's going to be up there. I mean, even once we get to the Renaissance, which is the best era of Disney ever, Bambi is going to be high still.
Yeah.
How good it is. So, I don't know. Do you agree with that ranking at all?
I agree with the first one and the last one.
So Bambi's number 1?
Yeah, Bambi's
and Fantasia's number 5?
Yeah, number 5.
Okay.
And then the second one for me will be Dumbo.
Then Dumbo.
And then...
Pinocchio.
The third one will be Pinocchio. Snow White. And then Fantasmic. Fantasia, sorry.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So go from bottom to... Your 5 is Fantasia. Uh-huh. Your 4 is Snow White. Mm-hmm. Your 3 is Pinocchio. Mm-hmm. 2 Dumbo, 1 Bambi.
Yeah.
Okay.
So far. Okay. I feel like it might change over time, but so far, yeah.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, but this is it. All right. Yeah. There's nothing else. It was killing me. I was like, there's something I'm missing, something really important. And it's literally the point of the video. Yeah. We're ranking these. Mm-hmm. So, Francis, my wife.
Yes, Jonathan.
Is there anything that you want to plug in before we go where people can follow you?
My Instagram. Francis Fash.
Fash as in like spell it
fashion.
Out.
Fash.
Yes.
Francis with an E. Francis.
And you also have a kind of...
I have a Disney
Instagram
account.
Instagram, yeah.
But I haven't used it in a while. I might get back into it. Who knows? Maybe I'll post like something every month or every 2 months. It's called Francis at the Parks. So you can follow me in both.
Yeah, I mean, I'm there too. But if you guys like this video, you want to continue supporting this channel, if you're watching this on YouTube, like this video, subscribe to the channel, comment down below. If you're listening to this on podcast form, make sure you rate, make sure you review, make sure you share this with your friends, and everything else that you do with podcasts, because I'm still new to the podcast game. The Man of Movies podcast everywhere. Instagram at Man of Movies 96. Man of Movies 96. The Man of Movies podcast, ladies and gentlemen. The first episode of the golden era of Disney. We've been trying to do this forever.
We have.
And we're finally pulling the trigger. And let's just keep this rolling. We got a whole bunch more to go. But I mean, once we look back, it's going to be a nice little project that we did to look back. So yeah, that's it.
We did it.
Goodbye.
Bye.